Tragedies are commonplace. All kinds of diseases people are slipping away. The economy's down, people can't get enough pay. But as for me, I said, as for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, hey, for all you've done for me. You see, there are folks without homes. They're living out in the streets, and the drug habits. I'm not just talking about folks out in the street, but right in the church, drug habits that some folks hiding just can't beat. There are mothers and robbers. No place seems to be safe, Lord, but you've been my protection. Hey, you've been my protection every step of the way. Yes, you have, Lord. Yes, you have, Lord. Yes, you have, Lord. And I want to say, and I want to say, and I want to say,
thank you.
Thank you. want to thank you for participating in our service. We want to let you know that this is a place where the Spirit of God dwells. You can come into this house and you can praise God in your own way. If you're not in the house, you can still praise God. You can raise your hand, you can clap your hand, you can pat your feet. But understand that this is New Bethlehem Baptist Church. This is the house of bread. This is where you will be fed. I want you to come on in and just praise God in the sanctuary. Praise Him in your heart and let everybody know that everything that you do here will be all right. Amen.
Thank you. We ask now, Lord, that you will continue to lead, guide, and direct us. As we go through this day, O Lord, we ask that you would just be with us. Allow the anointing of the Holy Spirit to fall fresh upon us. And as we take and hear your word, Lord, let us glean from it that which you have us to learn, that we may apply it to our lives and move forward with it and do your will. This precious son, Jesus' name, amen. Today, I'm going to take a scripture from our Sunday school lesson. For all of you that didn't attend Sunday school over the last couple of weeks, after listening to it, it sounded so good, I decided to just go ahead on and preach it. Today's sermon will be coming out of James chapter 1, verses 1 through 4. In James chapter 1, starting at verse 1, if you have your Bibles, you may find these words in the King James Version. James, a servant of God and the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribe which is scattered abroad, greetings. My brothers, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be able, or may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. We'll stop right there. For I thought with this message, count it all joy. Every now and then you find yourself deep in the midst of trials and tribulations, and you don't know what to do. But we're going to take a look at James, and he says that when you fall into your diverse temptation, when you fall into your colors of temptation, count it all joy. One of the things that we have to learn is that we are going to go through some types of trials. So there comes a time when it seems like things are just going wrong all the time, and people are complaining and just going through all manner of things. No matter how hard you work, it seems like that whatever you do is not good enough. But don't worry, you're not by yourself. For we have all been hurt, disappointed, challenged, and overwhelmed when we go through our trials and our tribulations. You know, I'm here to tell you that everything will be all right. Yes, we're in a pandemic. Yes, we still having to social distance to a point, still to stay at home. And for some of us, we haven't been out to a restaurant to eat in the last 5-6 months. And you know, things are going to get better. But right now, we have to look at it and say everything will be all right. But first, we got to understand that everything is not all right right now. So the statement in itself says that everything is not all right. It will be all right. But one of the things you got to understand that even though they are not right right now, God is still in charge. Yes, you're going to have to cry sometimes over the things that are going on. Well, we're listening to our president and all the things he's got going on. We're looking for a new pandemic, a new stimulus packet, but yet our illustrious congressman says over his dead body. You know, one of the things we got to understand is that we got to depend on the Lord God Almighty, because the government is not going to be there for us. So you understand that you will struggle. But you need to know, even though you're going to be struggling, and then there's going to be moments when you're going to be frustrated, aggravated, antagonized, you still have to just hold on to your faith, knowing that God is still in charge and that everything's going to be all right. See, you will walk the floor at night sometimes worried about where the next action is going to come from, where the next meal for some worried about whether or not they're going to be able to stay in their houses, that, you know, that the order has been lifted. Now evictions are going on, letters are going out, creditors are after people. There are all types of things, and you're getting aggravated, and you're getting frustrated. So you got to understand that this is just a natural course. James says, count it all joy when you fall into your diverse temptation. Now, you got to understand, if you look up the word divers, that diver says the color. Everybody got a temptation of different colors, just like the mask going around. Some people got on blue mask, some got on pink mask, some got on black mask, some got on gray mask. Well, everybody's got a different color of temptation. So when you come down to your temptation, he says you need to just count it all joy. Yeah, if you go back into the Word of God, it says that the Psalms 34:19 tells us that many are the affliction of the righteous. Sometimes you will just have to go through your trial. You know, one of the things we have to understand, God put trials on us to strengthen us. We don't just get into temptation. We don't just get into the trials just so that we can be put into a trial to see how we're going to go. God knows the outcome, but he wants you to understand the outcome. Some of us want to take and try to skip that trial, say, it's too much. I can't handle that. Well, God knows what you can handle, and he put it on you so that you can be strong enough, or that you will know that you are strong enough to do what he calls on you to do. So whenever your trial seems to be getting the best of you, James says that you need to just take and count it all joy. Don't worry about what's going to happen next, because God is still in charge. See, James understood, because he was the older brother of Jesus, one of his siblings of Jesus the Christ. He was there to witness the appearance of Jesus Christ at his resurrection. He was among those who assembled together following his ascension into heaven. And he wanted to come, he waited on the coming of the Holy Spirit. Later, he became a leader and believers of the Jerusalem church. He had a relationship with the people, and he wanted to let them know that everything was going to be all right. But one of the things that he wanted to make sure you understood is that your fellowship is great. That we need to fellowship one with another. He said, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. See, you got to be patient with some of the things that's going on right now. Because if you try to rush through it, you're not going anywhere. You got to have patience and know that the God is still in charge. We have to wait and know that one of the things that with our patience, he says that knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that she may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. If you are waiting on the Lord, you are not waiting to get something, but you know that you're waiting on the Lord, that he's going to take care of the things that's going on. Our life has been in a turmoil for so long that we don't know which way to go. We're waiting on something to happen. We want to get back into the church, but yet we keep finding out it's not yet. Well, every time you think that it's getting close to time to come back in, the numbers start going back up. The number of activity, the number of problems keeps going up. So you got to learn how to be patient and wait on the Lord. But one of the things that you have to understand is that God is still in charge. While God is taking care of everything, you need to just wait on him. You can't rush God in with what he's doing. I know some of us think that this pandemic, as some have told me, it's all a hoax. It's the government just trying to keep everybody into this whirlwind of things that's going on around about us. But understand that this pandemic is real. This pandemic is killing people. And if you are not doing what you need to do to protect yourself, even if you're not protecting yourself, everything you're doing may cause harm to somebody else. So when you're talking about your trial and your tribulation is to be able to walk with your mask on, to go into places knowing that you are not only protecting yourself, but you are taking and not spreading whatever is going on around to the next person along with you. One of the things we got to understand that going through and wondering what's going on in our life, there is always the potential to somebody to come along. Now, let's get real. We every time we start trying to say that, well, you know, things seem like it's getting better and maybe we should do this, that, and the other. I'm going to tell you, stand still. Wait on the salvation of the Lord. The Lord is still going to do what he's going to do. He's still in charge. He's greater than any pandemic. He's greater than any virus. He is greater than anything. He created plagues that nobody can handle. But yet he can handle all of them. So I want you to understand, count it all joy when you come into your divers temptation. But above all, I want you to understand that all sickness, according to the word of God, is not unto death. There are some that will get it and some that will recover and some that won't. But whatever the outcome is, God is still in charge. See, See, you got to know that you need to hold on to his unchanging hand. And when it seems like you don't have any place to go, you need to go back to the fundamentals and basics of what we have always been taught. If you want a cure, if you want action, you want something done, you need to go back and talk to the master. You need to learn how to go into your secret closet and let him know what's going on in your life. And if everything is not all right at that point, yeah, go back and talk to him some more. I know some said that when you talk to the master, you give it to him and then you don't bring it back up. Well, I'm going to tell you that I have learned that I need to call on his name every day. And every time I call on him and I don't get an answer, I'm going to come back and say, Lord, I'm still waiting on you. I still got a problem out here. I know that you are the problem solver. I know that you can handle every problem that I got, but I can't hear from you, Lord. So I don't know what's going on. So then I have to go back and take a look at myself. I go back and start wondering what's wrong with me, because I know I got a perfect God. I need to go back and talk to the master a little more. I said, well, Lord, I got to get into your word, because if I find what I need in the word of God, then that means that you've already given me a promise. And because you promised it to me, and because I can find it in the word, I know that you're going to do it, and the answer to my prayer is coming. It might not be right now. I may have to wait on it, because you said not yet. But you know the outcome of the situation before it even starts. I'll have to learn how to just wait on you and act like what it is that James Taylor told us to do. You need to be patient and let patience have its perfect work. And that patience that will bring it to a point that you will be entire and wanting nothing. I don't want anything. All I want to know is that do I have your loving kindness, that I have your grace and your mercy, and that when I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I've got grace on one side and mercy on the other. So, Lord, I'm calling on you today to give me grace and mercy. But above all, Lord, I want you to ease my trials. So while I'm going through my trials and my tribulation, regardless of what color my trial may be, I'm going to count it all joy, because it my joy comes from you. And I'm going to seek out your salvation. I'm going to seek your faith for each and every turn. So I'm just going to wait on you, Lord. And when it comes time for me to give it all up, I'm going to be ready to receive an answer from you. Count it all joy when you go into your diverse temptation. Amen.
Amen. We thank God for the spoken word. The opportunity is given to each and every one of us, knowing that there may be someone that, wherever they're at this hour in their home, may not know the Lord as their personal Savior. But I can assure you, with the condition of this world today, everyone needs to know who Jesus is. You can decide to follow Jesus. All you have to do is confess with your mouth. And you can pick up the telephone and call the church and just ask for the pastor. And he will be willing as far as to pray with you. And you can be a member of the church. But we thank God for you if you do. And certainly I can assure you that it'll be the best decision you ever made in your life, knowing that you have given your life to Christ. Tomorrow is promised to no one. There are three ways into the Baptist Church: by letter, by Christian experience, by baptism. Whichever way you choose, you can give your life to Christ. Then we will translate it to altar call. We all desire prayer. The condition of this world today, we all need prayer. We see what's happening, and we need as far as to call on the Lord. So wherever you are in your home this morning, you can bow your head with me while we go to the throne of grace. Father, Father, in the name of Jesus, it's once more and again that we have come We just come to say thank you, God, because we realize that you have been good to us. Despite my Heavenly Father not being in the church house, but God, you are still God. And Father, we thank you, O God, for the provision that you have provided for us. Lord, I realize, my Heavenly Father, that someone went to bed last night. But then my Heavenly Father realized that they need you at this hour, knowing, my Heavenly Father, what they're going through. With all that are going around us, so many of us are feeling the pressure. We are being stressed out because we don't know, my Heavenly Father, one day from the next. But I know, my Heavenly Father, that we serve a God that is able to do all things but fail. And Lord, this morning I ask, oh God, that you look down upon these thy people. We ask, oh God, to let them know, my Heavenly Father, that you is God beside you. There is none other. We ask, oh God, that you look upon each home that are represented from New Bethlehem Baptist Church. Bless them, my Heavenly Father, one by one and name by name. Then, my Heavenly Father, if it so please, Lord, look down upon those that are sick among us. We ask, O God, that you touch them right now. Let them know, my Heavenly Father, that they are not forgotten. Lord, my Heavenly Father, you are still on your throne. And Father, I know, my Heavenly Father, that you will move when you get ready. But Father, we say thank you now, Lord. But when we look back over our lives, you realize you have brought us from a mighty long way. We thank you, O God, for everything that you have done. And Father, we praise you, O God, for the things that you're about to do. We ask, O God, my Heavenly Father, continue to hold our hand. Bless each and every one of us right now. But Father, we say thank you. And then, Lord, we ask, O God, look down upon our young people. Lord, they need you, my Heavenly Father, right now. Lord, build a fence all around them. Cover them, O God, with your precious blood, if you only so please. But Father, we said thank you. And Father, when it's all said and done, we will give you the praise and give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
What is that?
this is another opportunity to continue to support the church in these times of trouble. Though we may not be able to assemble ourselves here, you can always go to the church website, newbethlehembc.org, and you can continue to give your tithes and offerings unto the church. On that page, on the web page, you will find a link to Givelify, which gives you the opportunity to give over the internet. The church doors are also open on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday from 10 unto 2 if you wish to come by and to drop off your tithes and your offering. Also understand that the doors are open that you may come in to pray. There's normally someone here during those hours, so feel free to come and join us, knowing that we will continue to uplift the name of Jesus, even though we cannot assemble ourselves together in this house. Amen.